Now, let's talk about some of the examples of the haya of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how he conducted himself. When people used to describe Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and wallahi al-azim, for the even for us men, you know, sometimes we think the haya is something that is special to only the women. No. Yes, the most important thing that makes a woman beautiful, the most important thing that makes a woman beautiful is haya. But yet, men should have haya too. You know, it's less amount. But the haya, anything that is haya is good. One time, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to just kind of emphasize this point, he saw a brother, you know, condemning his own brother about how much extra haya he have. You know, he told him, "You have so much haya. How can you do this?" Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, he said, "What anything is haya is good. Anything from haya is good. Anybody who have any haya is good, no matter small, big. Anything if you have haya, it's good. So that's why we have to increase a bit." Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, people who describe, look at how they describe Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. كان أشد حياء من العذراء في صدرنا. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was have more حياء, more than a virgin in her own womb. So when he talked, he was shy. When he the kind of language that he utters, it spoke shyness. When he even يعني subhanAllah, when he wanted to condemn something, he was shy. Yeah, probably, they used to say, you know how they used to know that someone have done wrong in front of him? They would look at the face of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, she used to be upset, and he would his face would turn red. Now, some of us, when we are upset, we might yell and condemn, and then we scorn, we say bad things. But out of the haya of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is how he used to conduct himself.